First of all, the growth is coming from projects in Qatar, in Canada, China, Australia, etc. So Nigeria didn't have new projects coming on stream. Now on Nigeria, I think the court made a few rulings which are very important. The first ruling is it ruled that all the four cases were sabotage, so not actually done by Shell. They were actually by criminals who steal products. The second one is it therefore dismissed all the NGO claims from Friends of the Earth. It said in one claim that when the judge looked at it, that Shell could have done somewhat more to protect the pipelines to make it a little bit less, not that easy to actually steal product. And that's really what the court ruled. It did not rule that we had actually spilled or did anything else.
Are you going to be doing that and putting money aside to try and tackle that situation?
We have been doing this for years. So we are burying pipelines, we are putting cement on everything. So I need to look at this specific case now, but in a more strategic sense. We have been doing this now for 2-3 years, and we will continue to that, to make it even more difficult, quasi impossible, that, or at least it makes it very difficult, that they actually dig up the pipelines again and drill holes in it and steal the products.
OK, going forward, obviously, this case in Nigeria does, many people say, represent a bit of a landmark change, let's say, in the relationship between some African countries and big oil producers. Obviously, you're bringing enormous technology over to Nigeria. Oil is a huge part of the economy there. Do you view this as changing your relationship with some of these African partners as well, to make sure that, obviously, extracting oil is less environmentally dangerous, less at risk of sabotage?
I think this will not change anything, because clearly we are a responsible operator and we have proven this over many decades. We are using global standards wherever we are operating. If it's in the African continent, Asian or American, it really doesn't matter. We work together with the government, with local and let's say governments, so central and local governments, and we are performing at the best in all of these countries. So this will not change our way we do business. It has just been a great proven point now that it is not Shell actually spilling it.
Let me ask you briefly your predictions for the year to come. How's it looking for Shell?
I think if I look at the globe, I see a more positive 2013 compared to 2012. I see that the US during 2012, I have expectations that the economy will grow. I see Asia and Middle East more positive. I'm a little bit less positive on Europe. I see that still as a slow growth in 2013, potentially 14. But I would think that the general economy and therefore the consumption of energy will go up.